Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, I'm covering a subject I've wanted to do for a long time, dwarf planets. Observing dwarf planets is largely ignored in amateur astronomy, probably because it is not as spectacular as some of the beautiful nebulae and galaxies visible in the night sky. So, before I get into what I've managed to observe and how to observe a dwarf planet yourself, I thought it is a good idea to provide some background information on dwarf planets. The whole idea of dwarf planets is fairly new, and many people can probably remember how it came about. Since the discovery of Pluto in 1930, there have been 9 planets in our solar system for many years. However, when Eris was discovered in 2005, which is slightly bigger than Pluto, it put Pluto's status as a planet into doubt. After estimates that there might be 100 other similar planets yet to be discovered in the outer solar system, what a planet is as a concept was clearly defined for the first time. The definition is as follows. A planet has to be in the orbit of the Sun and not a moon. It has to be round and have cleared the neighbourhood around its orbit. Those planets not fulfilling this last requirement are described as dwarf planets. And so, Pluto was duly demoted, amid many protests, to a dwarf planet. Most of these dwarf planets can be found in the outer reaches of the solar system. Such distances pose a problem for the amateur astronomer, because they are so far away they are difficult to see with amateur equipment. Very dark skies are required, and probably a 12 to 14 inch telescope to see the dwarf planet Pluto visually. Pluto, at its brightest, is only a dim magnitude of 13.65, while the other dwarf planets in the outer solar system, such as Eris, require even larger telescopes. However, during the protests about Pluto's demotion from planethood, there was one promotion from asteroid to dwarf planet, in the much closer to home asteroid belt, Ceres. Ceres was discovered in 1801, and was, along with several other objects, thought to be planets. This led to a situation in the early 19th century when there were many more planets in the solar system than we have today, until they were reclassified as asteroids due to their small size. However, Ceres is massive enough to be classified as a dwarf planet. Unlike Pluto and the other dwarf planets, Ceres is much brighter, with a brightness magnitude of 6.7. which is just out of being visible with the naked eye, but visible in binoculars and above. Indeed, it was visible in my 50mm finescope, which is the equivalent of a pair of binoculars. All of this makes Ceres a great target for the amateur astronomer, wanting to see a dwarf planet. So, how do you identify a dwarf planet? Well, unfortunately, unlike the main planets, they can't be identified from the fact that they have a planetary disk. Instead, they look like a star. But this shouldn't be surprising when you realise that Ceres only has a diameter of 946 km and is out beyond the orbit of Mars. So instead, I would recommend first attempting to view Ceres when it is in opposition. This will mean it appears as bright as it can be when observing. The second tip is to look at a star chart to see its current location in the sky. The position of all the planets is always changing, so you will need to use a planetarium app if possible, such as Stellarium. A great technique is to wait for Ceres to be near something more obvious in the night sky, such as a major planet or bright star. You can then use this as a signpost to your target. You will want to use a low power magnification, as this will allow you to see more of the night sky and be able to see Ceres' movement amongst the stars. As Ceres will look like a star when you locate it, to identify it for sure you'll need to take a photograph or draw what you are seeing, then come back the following night or so and repeat the process. Then when you compare the two images, you should see that one of the stars has moved, and that should be Ceres. As shown in these two images, I managed to take over 2 consecutive nights. As you can see, in just one night, Ceres has moved quite a bit. It is also important to make your images or drawings over 2 nights close together to ensure that the same stars are in both images, so that the movement of Ceres is observable. However, this is not all you can do. Brightness of the dwarf planet can be measured between each observation, which may change due to alternating surface features, such as Ceres' white spot. This theoretically could be used to indicate this planet's spin speed. I know to some people who are more used to seeing episodes on more visually impressive objects in the night sky, that this must be somewhat of an anticlimax. But being able to confirm that I observed a dwarf planet was a highlight of my journey through amateur astronomy. If you like this episode, then please leave a like. If you have any questions, just comment below. And for more astronomy videos, please do subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.